A very cordial good afternoon to everyone. I am Ishrat Chahan Shah from FYBSCIT, Sangukana Thakur Arts, Commerce and Science College, New Panvel Autonomous. And today I am going to explain you all about the topic DDL statement in DBMS. So first, let us understand what is DBMS. DBMS, that is database management system, refers to the running of storing and retrieval of data and using queries in data. So create is a DDL statement, and today we are going to study about creating a table in database management system. So first, let us understand why we use create table statement in database management system. So the syntax for creating a table in database management system is as follows: create table, table name. Then we have to give all the column names and their data types. So create is a DDL statement. DDL stands for data definition language statement. Table is an object of database, and our table name is the object name. So table name, we have to specify our particular table name. Then we have to give the bracket. Then under the bracket, we have to specify all the columns that we want to give in our table, and it is compulsory to specify the data type along with the column name. So we have given here column 1, then its data type, then column 2 along with its data type, column 3, up to column n number of column can be created in a table. So we have to end it with a closing bracket along with the semicolon. So let us understand how to create a table in a database management system by using a simple example. So here we are going to create a student database, that is student table, in the database management system. So we have here create table, that is our format, and here our table name is student, so we have taken it as student. Then our opening bracket, then under it our all columns, that is first column, that is student ID, its data type is number. It specifies us and allows us to enter only number values inside our column. So here it is important to give the data type along with the column name. Next, we give a comma to end to tell the database that the column 1 is completed. Then we have second column, that is student first name, and its data type is varchar. And inside, after varchar, we have given a bracket, so we can specify the number of characters that can be entered in that particular column. Varchar means the characters which are included in our column. It is a data type. Then third column is student last name with its data type as varchar, and number of characters are 10. Next, comma. Then our fourth column is student phone number, and its data type is number. So the user can enter only number values in the student phone number column. Next, comma. Then student address, another column. Then its data type varchar, and 50 characters can be included. Then whenever our column are completed in a table, we have to give a closing bracket along with the semicolon. The semicolon tells the database that our number of columns are completed and our table is completed. So our columns in our tables are completed. Thank you.